This is Nurse Rose, and I'm here with our patient's daughter. This is our final session together. Can you please state for the record why?
There's not much left to say that hasn't already been said. She's fragmented by the time. She's never herself. Not her true self, at least. Whatever she's seen in me, it's monstrous. I can't do this anymore.
These things take time.
How long? I've wasted 8 years of my life waiting for an absolution, and I can't wait anymore. If she really cares about me, she'll wake up. Please wake up.
This is the end. This is what everything is leading up to.
Thank you. Directly to the edge.
Memories are not facts. They are interpretations. Just stories we tell ourselves. Like the story of the undying love between you and your daughter. Please accept my gift. I hope it will shed light on your new perspective.
We built this world together. The people, the architecture, the rules. Everything was created from our imagination. Then this nurse came and ruined it all.
mother.
Then act like one. When was the last time you were home for more than a few hours? When the hell was the last time you parented instead of keeping me locked up from the world?
I was just trying to protect you.
If you tried harder, this would never have happened. How long was your trip, though?
Stressful, honey. Sometimes it just isn't fair.
Why isn't it fair?
It's something you don't need to worry about until later when you get older. Then we can talk about it.
How long ago was the last time you saw me?
You know it's sad when your mother sees other people more than her own daughter.
These people are my friends, and they paid for everything we have.
And I'm sure they were just friends. But we're a family. We're meant to look out for each other, not tear each other down. Before you go, Rose came by with some of your medication. She told me to give it to you. Did you just throw a plate at me?
I'm sorry, I've been dealing with so much lately.
What kind of pressure could you feel? Are you back on your meds?
No, and I don't need them. Every time I take them, I'm not myself. There's this picture I want you to see. I promised one day I was going to take you with me.
You've been asking me to do that for years. What makes this picture so special?
The picture's about us.
Is this why you weren't around?
No, it wasn't me that wasn't around.
I've seen that look before. I think we both know what's going on. Mom, welcome back home. I've been waiting for so long.
Damn.
Again? How long this time?
Won't be long. I promise I'll be back.
Some left you a gift. Don't you want to see what's inside?
I always get gifts. You know what? You take it. I think you deserve it more than me.
I don't even know what it is.
Well, be sure to tell me whenever I get back. I'm sure it'll be a huge surprise.
The best gift to give to someone is an absolution. The ability to trust each other again, and in your case, to be part of a family. With that, our time is drawing to a close. Open the doors and show the world the truth. Show them who you really are.
name is Dahlia, and this is my story. How it starts and how it ends. You didn't get the role, but you were able to do something else, for better or worse. You survived. It's been a while since you were out, but I'm fairly certain you can do this. This is your story, and you should embrace it. We're almost at the premiere. I know it's not easy for you, but you need to face what you couldn't, and show the world who you really are. Good luck.
I've been waiting for this moment forever. We're early too, with a few minutes to spare. You kept your promise, you really did. All my friends will be so jealous. I can't wait to see their faces when I tell them. When I grow up, I'm going to bring my kids here too. I still can't believe my mom is the Great Marie, the greatest detective in the world. This is really the best gift anyone could have ever given to me. I wonder what's inside.
Do you know any good stories?
I'm afraid I don't.
Well, what if I teach you how to tell a good story? And then maybe you can tell me one?
Okay.
Every story consists of three parts. The first part is the introduction. It's when you meet the main character for the very first time. You get to see their day-to-day life before anything happens. But of course, something does. Something always happens. Or there would be no story. That is when we reach the second part. The middle. Our character encounters change. They could lose someone close to them, or journey to new places. We will meet characters that will sway them like a pendulum. How our character handles this will dictate the final part. The part where our character embraces all these changes, or fights to stay the same. This is the part we like to call the end.
Thank you.